person who look on other people from day to day, watching them succeed and wonder how they do it? Have you ever wondered why you have never been successful at planning your life goals and have it materialize? How badly are you in need of success right now? And what are you planning to do this year to achieve your life goals? Today we're going to talk about this and more. Welcome to Psychology at Work. Welcome back to the channel. I'm happy that you're able to join me today. Before we go any further, I want to say to you, go below and press that red button so you can continue to get consistent teaching tools and tips to help your life become better. So go ahead, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and if at the end of this session you enjoy it, you can go ahead and like it, and I will appreciate that very much. Today we're going to talk about how to design your life so you can live very successful. I'm going to show you 9 points that you can use to make sure your life is successful this year. So go ahead, enjoy, get your pens, get your papers, and you are going to be doing a work through activity. You're going to be writing down things. So in order for you to plan your goals and to be successful at it, you need to make sure you have all the relevant tools. So get a pen, get your paper, and come prepared. We are about to get rolling. I am going to start by defining our goals. You know, every year, the beginning of the year, we talk about goals and achieving goals, and we talk about vision and all these other things. But what really are goals? They are simply dreams with deadlines. They are dreams with deadlines. And we continue to set goals year in, year out. But did you know that the average person makes their goals 10 times or more without success? The average person makes their goals 10 times or more without success. So it's a trend where every new year, people go ahead and make their plans, but they never carry it through. And there are quite a few reasons why people never carry their goals and their plans through. And we'll talk about those in part two. I want to look at even what the Bible is saying about our visions and setting our goals and achieving them. Proverbs, it talks about without vision, the people will perish. So everybody needs to create their vision and work with your goals. Come on, let's jump into the whole camp. We are going to get our hands real dirty planning our life goals. Come on, roll into the whole camp, guys. Ready? Here we go. Let us continue looking at how to design your life successfully this year, 2023. We are going to start with the first stage of this goal setting process. As one, you must have a desire, something that you want real bad. That's the first thing we're going to talk about. You have to make whatever it is that you need personal, and it must be intense or something that is burning within you. And you must believe that this desire that you have in you is very, very possible to achieve, right? And so you must convince yourself. You must convince yourself that this is something that you want and you can make into a reality, right? You must be confident in believing that this goal that you want to achieve is possible. Because if you don't believe that your goal is possible and you can achieve it, who else is going to believe you? So the first thing you have to do, create that desire for something to happen in your life that you want to achieve. The second step in your goal setting process is to write down everything that you want. You have to put things on paper, because if you do not put things on paper, then it only becomes a thought in your head. It has not been formalized, and it is nothing that you want to process. All right? Earl Nightingale, I'm reading from my notes here. Earl Nightingale says, people with goals succeed because they know where they are going. So, writing down your goals is like a roadmap. It leads you to where you want to go. You want to have that constant reminder. So here's what you do. You take 7 minutes. 7 minutes. And you can pause this video when I'm finished with the instructions. And then you can do, and then you come. Because we want to make it as practical as possible. So write down everything you want in your life for this year, maybe for the future. But remember, it starts with one step. So write down all that it is that you want as your goal, or all that you desire. In 7 minutes, you make sure you have all of this written down. And when you're doing, you want to break it up also. So you can look at your personal goals. What is it that you want personally for yourself? Where you want to develop, how you want to develop. And then you can look at your business goals. Is it that you want to improve your business this year? Or is it that you want to start your business this year? Is it that you're looking to join a company, an organization? How do you proceed this year? And then you can also look at your wellness goals. A lot of people make wellness goals. Your wellness goals could be that you want to eat a little better, or you want to take off some weight, you want to get physically fit a little more. You know, these are your wellness goals. Is it that you want to take better care of your health in terms of taking your medication and do as your doctor instructs you to do? And then you want to look at your financial goals. Are you comfortable with the amount of money that you have, the amount of money that you have working, the income that you have? Are you in debt? Do you have credit card debt? Do you have school loans? Do you have other loans that you have that you need to strategize how to clear up all of these loans? Look at your financial goals. And then you also want to look at your relationship goals. Is it that you want to improve your relationship with your spouse? Is it that you want to have a better relationship with your children? Is it that you want to, you know, maintain better relationship with your co-workers, your colleagues? What is it that you want? So look at all of these. Use 7 minutes and put all of them, no matter how pathetic you think they sound, put them on paper. And so we're going to talk about them. Okay? So get all your goals and your dreams and your desires on paper and out of your head. And Brian Tracy, one of the greatest philosophers, someone who focuses a lot on goals and dreams, here is what he says. Put them on paper where you can touch them. He says there is a connection between the head and the hand. And when you engage in a, when you put it on paper, here is what happens in the brain. You engage in a psychoneuromotor activity, right? And it creates visual powers within you and audio powers. and your kinesthetic powers are activated. So it programs right away, straight into your unconscious mind, where it starts to work 24 hours per day. So writing down your goals, your desires, your plans is important because it triggers a lot of activities going on, and it goes over and over and over in your mind over 24 hours of the day. So as you write down your goals or your dreams, you want to ensure you're asking yourself the following questions. What do I want to accomplish for myself? How do I want to show up for myself this year? So you may have written 20 things, 30 things, but what I want you to do now is go back through all of those desires that you have on paper and identify the top 10. Choose the top 10 that you have on the paper, and you want to rank them in order of priority. Which one is more important, and which one comes next, and which one comes next? And you're going to be asking yourself some important questions also as you get to this aspect. Which ones motivate you most? What would be the reward making this goal happen? What if I achieve this goal, what am I going to get out of it? How am I going to be rewarded? What is the satisfaction that I will get? The fourth stage, or the fourth part of the process of setting your goals and achieving your desires in a successful way, is to re-examine the goals. So you have your goals on paper and you have 10 of them. I want you to go back and look at each of them, and you want to make sure that you're setting SMART goals. What are SMART goals? Then you want the S for SMART means specific. You know, many times we pray and we ask God for things, but we don't know how to even ask for things. I learned that we need to be specific when you pray, right? So that's a very important part of setting your goal. Be specific. Say exactly what it is that you want. I want to clear off my $5,000 credit card this year. I want to pay off my school fee that I owe from last term by the end of March. Be specific with whatever it is that you're going to set as a goal. M in SMART stands for measurable. I want to do this. I want to do 3 key things this year. I want to achieve these 3 things. So make sure that the M is measurable. The A in SMART means attainable. Make sure you set a goal that is something that you can attain. Don't set unrealistic goals that you know you won't be able to achieve. So you have to ensure it is attainable. Then you want to make sure it is realistic. Don't tell yourself you want to make $1 million by now in March when you don't have a system to make that happen. All right? You have to be realistic with something that you've been doing over the years and you have not reached the goal. Something is wrong with the goal, right? So it must be realistic. Then the other thing you want to look at is time bound. T for in the end of SMART, time bound. Put timelines to it. So you want to achieve this by the end of the month. You want to achieve this by December 31st. So now that you have all your plans on paper, you have re-examined them, and you're asking yourself, why do you want all of these? Then it is important for you to move to the sixth stage, which is to make a plan. The sixth stage of your goal setting process is to actively make plans. So you're going to make a plan, That's the action step process. So what you do, you write down all the steps that you plan to take to make your goals happen, and then you analyze your starting point. Acknowledge where you are at this moment. Acknowledge that, okay, here I am. I want to do these three things, but the reality is, this is where I am at. Acknowledge that you are presently not necessarily in a good position to get to a certain stage in the next 3 months or 6 months. And then you need to start looking then at the obstacles that will prevent you from achieving your dreams. And I want to tell you, according to what persons who would have been doing this goal setting for many years and doing the efficient research, here is what they indicated, that 80% of what we achieve is from within, and the 20% is from external. So we have the power and the potential to make our dreams a reality. The 20% that's left externally, it cannot prevent us from achieving. So we have to look at our starting point, where we are now, where we intend to go, what is preventing me, and what else do I need to do. And then we move on to stage 7. So as you transition into stage 7 of the process of planning your goal, one other important thing you want to look at is identifying what is your 1 year goal versus what is your 5 year goal. Remember, we talk about setting timelines. Some of the goals, they have to be reasonable, in the sense that you cannot set a particular goal that you know you cannot achieve this year on your paper, because you're going to become frustrated at the end of the year and you have not achieved that goal. So it is important for you to set your goals in a 1 year towards a 5 year. And most of you, when you go to an interview, you maybe notice the interview will ask, where do you see yourself in 5 years? Because that's a standard part of goal setting. You look at a 5 year span. You look at now, the here and the now, and then you look at 5 years from now, where you are. So the next step we're going to move in step 7 is to identify the additional skills and resources that you will need. Sometimes we are asking for certain promotion in the workplace, but then you don't realize that the promotion will require of you to have adequate training or more training. But some of us want to reach that level and we don't want to take on the additional task. If it is that you're going to have to do a 4-year study or a 2-year study, you have to make up your mind. No one has ever said to you that life is going to be easy. Life is not easy. Life is hard. From the day you are born until now, life is hard. And you have to achieve things. You plan smarter, right? You learn to plan smarter instead of harder. And so that is how you are going to achieve your goals, right? So you have to look at what additional skills do you need to practically make sure that you're achieving those goals. And Jim Quick makes a serious statement, and I keep looking back at it. He says, if you fight for your limitations, you get to keep them. If you fight for your limitations, you get to keep them. So you have some people, each time you say, oh, you're not going to do so and so. Oh, well, I don't think I'm smart enough. I'm too old now to go and get this done. I am not educated enough to achieve this. And if you continue, what he's pretty much saying is, if you continue to claim all of these limitations, and every time someone says something to you, all we're hearing is the negatives and the can't and how what is limiting you, then automatically you own it, you hold on to it, and you never let it go. Very profound statement. But if you had the power in the next 24 hours to change your life, what would that look like? What would be the one thing that needs to change for you to be successful and to realize your dream and to accomplish those plans that you have? What would that look like? The next stage in this goal setting process is to put your goals in plain sight. A lot of people make their plans and you put it under the mattress, or you put it in your drawer, or you leave it at work, or you just put it somewhere and hope it will act by itself. Now, it is important when you put your goals that are written out somewhere that you can see them, right? You have to see them, be reminded of them. You get a chance to evaluate them because you're looking at them, you're seeing them, you're measuring them, you're knowing, you're recognizing whether you are achieving them or not. So it is very important to put your goals in plain sight. Again, I say, people with goals succeed because they know where they are going. And Earl Nightingale is the one that said that. People with goals succeed because they know where they are going. So the ninth and final stage is monitoring your achievements. Now, many times we set up ourselves, set our goals, and do all that the relevant processing entails. But then we do not measure them. We do not check on them. We do not evaluate and reassess if they are taking place. Now, if you don't evaluate and assess periodically, you won't know if you're making them or you're not. You have to know if you are achieving them or not. All right? So you have to reassess your whole deadline. Sometimes you set to say, oh, by the end of March, this is what you're going to be doing. Or by June, this is what you're going to be doing. But you have not been checking. What you want to do is ensure that you do your evaluation every month. Set a particular date, whether it's the beginning of the new month or the end of the month. Look at it and look at the timelines that you set, how close you are at achieving them. And if you are not achieving them, that's okay. Just set another timeline. So you don't have to become all frustrated and say because you missed two deadlines, you're not going to set anymore. Reassess and continue to set deadlines, because if you don't achieve them today, you'll achieve them tomorrow. It just takes a step to start a journey. One step to start a journey, right? So always remember to set your new deadlines. So if you find value in all that I have been saying, please subscribe to my channel that I can continue to provide you with adequate information and enough knowledge and awareness for you to improve and become successful in your life. I'm happy that you were able to join me on Psychology at Work and Play. And go and like this video. Go and subscribe and hit that notification bell. That means when the next video comes out, you'll be the first to know. I'm happy that I was able to share with you. Continue to gain knowledge. See you. Talk to you. Bye-bye. Later.